Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to show you how to edit videos like a pro using QuiCut. QuiCut is a powerful beginner-friendly video editor that comes with all the essential tools, from splitting clips, adjusting speed, adding end screens, to customizing animations and audio. Whether you're making videos for YouTube, TikTok, Instagram, or Facebook, this tutorial will guide you step by step. How to edit in QuiCut. First, open the QuiCut app. Your interface should look like this. Here, you'll find the new editing button. On the home screen, you'll also see some quick access options like camera, material, beauty, animation, and more. You'll find trending transitions, effects, and filters along with the local drafts section, where all your saved projects are stored. Now let's start a new project. To begin editing, simply tap on the new editing button. This will open your phone's gallery, where you can choose videos and photos to add to your project. You can even browse individual folders from the gallery for easy access. Let's go ahead and add a video. Here, I've selected one video. But remember, you can also choose multiple videos and images at the same time. Once you've made your selection, just tap the Add button. That's it! Your video is now added to the timeline, ready for editing. The editing screen in QuiCut looks very similar to CapCut. So if you've used CapCut before, this will feel familiar. At the top, you'll see the preview screen, where you can watch your video as you edit. Below the video track, you'll find the audio track and the subtitle track. And at the bottom, you'll see the editing panel, with all the tools you need. In today's session, we won't go deep into audio or subtitle editing. Instead, we'll focus on the essential editing tools, so you can start creating amazing videos right away. First, select the video clip you want to edit. Once it's selected, all the available editing tools will appear at the bottom of the screen. The very first tool we'll explore is Split. The Split tool lets you divide a single video clip into two separate parts at any point you choose. This is perfect when you want to trim, remove, or apply different effects to specific sections of your video. To use it, drag the playhead, the vertical line in the timeline, to the exact spot where you want to split the clip. Then, tap the Split button. Your clip is now divided into two separate clips. Once split, you can move, delete, or add effects to each part individually. This gives you complete control over your edits. Pro tip, you can split a clip multiple times if you want to make several cuts within the same video. How to use PIP, picture-in-picture, in QuiCut. Next, let's talk about the PIP feature in QuiCut. PIP stands for picture-in-picture, and it allows you to add another video, photo, or image on top of your main clip. This is perfect for reaction videos, tutorials, or adding logos and creative overlays. Here, three videos are running separately. I have just adjusted their size and placed them in three different positions on the screen. This shows how PIP can be used to layer multiple clips creatively for a dynamic video. How to add a PIP clip? First, make sure no clip is selected in your timeline. You can do this by deselecting your video or by tapping the double back arrow on the bottom toolbar. Once the main clip is deselected, tap on the PIP button. This will open your gallery where you can choose a video, image, or sticker to add. As soon as you select it, the PIP clip will appear in a new layer above your main video timeline. You can drag it, resize it, and position it anywhere on the preview screen. Editing your PIP clip, just like your main clip, PIP comes with its own editing tools. You can adjust opacity to make it more or less transparent. Apply animations to fade in, fade out, or move. Use basic properties like position, zoom, and rotate. Why use PIP? The PIP feature has many creative uses. Add a logo watermark to brand your video. Show a reaction video in the corner while the main clip plays. Add images, stickers, or emojis for fun. Place tutorial content like screen recordings on top of your main footage. Pro tip, don't overload your screen with too many PIP clips. Keep them neat and well-placed, so your main video stays the focus. How to add an end screen in QuiCut? Adding an end screen is very simple. Just tap on Add Ending. QuiCut has a cool and unique feature called the end screen. With this tool, you can add built-in end screens and customize them to make your videos look more professional. Here, you'll find lots of end screen samples. Select the one you like, then tap the check mark on the right. Your chosen end screen will be added to your video. To customize the end screen, tap the Edit icon. The Edit panel will open, where you can change the logo, nickname, and even add a description to make your ending more personal. Pro tip: take a moment to customize your end screen. It's a great way to leave a lasting impression on your viewers. How to make your video faster or slower in QuiCut. Next, let's talk about the speed option. With this tool, you can make your video play faster or slower depending on the effect you want. You'll find the speed option right beside the split tool. When you open it, you'll see two modes: regular speed and curve speed. Regular speed. From here, you can increase the playback speed up to 100 times for a fast motion effect. Or you can slow it down to 0.05x for smooth slow motion. Pro tip: use slow motion to highlight important or dramatic moments, and use fast motion to skip over long or less important parts of your footage. Curve speed. Now let's look at the curve speed option. Unlike regular speed, which changes the whole clip at one speed, curve speed lets you adjust the speed at different points of your video. Inside curve speed, you'll find several built-in presets like montage, hero, bullet, and jump cut. Each one creates a unique speed up and slow down effect, perfect for cinematic edits. You can also customize your own speed curve by adding points on the timeline and adjusting them. This gives you full control to create smooth slow motion and fast motion transitions within the same clip. Pro tip: use curve speed for creative effects. For example, slow down right before an important action, then speed up afterward for dramatic impact. My suggestion: experiment with different presets and settings to find out which style works best for your video. How to adjust volume in QuiCut. Next, let's look at the volume option. This tool allows you to increase or decrease the sound level of your video clip. You can even mute the original audio completely if you don't want any background noise. To adjust the volume, first select your video clip in the timeline, then tap on the volume tool from the bottom menu. Here, you'll see a slider control. Drag the slider to the right to make the audio louder, or drag it to the left to reduce the volume. If you slide it all the way down, your video will be completely muted. Pro tip: lower the clip's volume if you plan to add background music or a voiceover. This makes your final video sound cleaner and more professional. Denoise option. Right under the volume control, you'll also find the denoise option. This feature helps to reduce background noise from your video, like wind, traffic, or room echo. To use it, simply toggle on denoise. QuiCut will automatically clean up your audio, making voices clearer and reducing unwanted sounds. Pro tip: use denoise when recording in a noisy environment, but avoid overusing it, because sometimes it can make the audio sound unnatural. How to use basic properties in QuiCut. Next, let's explore the basic properties in QuiCut. This section gives you simple but powerful tools to fine-tune your video, making it look balanced and professional. Inside basic properties, you'll find three main controls: position, zoom, and rotate. Position. The position tool lets you move your video horizontally and vertically, using the X-axis and Y-axis sliders. The X-axis moves your video left or right. The Y-axis moves it up or down. This is very useful when you want to reframe your subject, fix off-center shots, or adjust composition after cropping. Zoom in. The zoom tool allows you to crop closer into your video. This is helpful when you want to highlight a subject or remove distracting edges from the frame. You can zoom in by dragging the slider or pinching directly on the preview screen. But remember, zooming too much may lower video quality. Rotate. The rotate option lets you adjust the angle of your video. You can rotate clockwise or counterclockwise to correct tilted footage or add a creative touch. Pro tip: small rotations can look stylish, but too much rotation may make the video hard to watch. How to use opacity in QuiCut. Next, let's talk about the opacity tool in QuiCut. This feature controls the transparency of your video clip, and it's very useful for creating overlays, ghost effects, or blending multiple clips together. What is opacity? Opacity simply means how solid or transparent your video appears on the screen. At 100% opacity, your video is fully visible. Lowering the opacity makes your video more transparent. At 0% opacity, the clip becomes completely invisible. How to adjust opacity? Select the clip in your timeline. Then tap on the opacity tool from the bottom menu. You'll see a slider control. Drag the slider left to reduce opacity, or right to increase it back to full visibility. Pro tip: opacity works especially well with text, images, or background videos. Use it to make your edits feel more cinematic, and that's how you can use opacity in QuiCut. A simple but powerful tool to make your edits more creative and professional. And that's it, friends. Now you know how to split clips, add end screens, adjust speed, control volume, and reduce noise in QuietCut. With these tools, you can turn your raw footage into professional-looking videos, ready for YouTube, TikTok, Instagram, or any platform you choose. Pro tip: don't be afraid to experiment. Try different speed effects, animations, and end screen designs to find your unique style. Practice makes perfect, and soon you'll be editing videos faster and more creatively than ever. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel for more easy-to-follow video editing tips. And as always, happy editing!